not be here tonight, so he sent me. Mark does my polling. He's done my polling all my career. Good news, I do pretty well, so Mark doesn't have much work. That means that I've saved some money. I am so pleased to be here with all of you. Oh, Elliot Engel is here.
Yeah!
Woo! Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, come on, man. Go. Good for you.
Just have my
bar mitzvah. Mazel tov.
Oh, Susan Wild from Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Elliot Engel,
Steny,
quickly points out, pandering as he does, a member of the Foreign Affairs Committee. I want to tell you that Elliot and I, as probably most of you know, are very, very close and dear friends. And I was just with Brad Schneider, and I have a little group that every time we have an issue, Pete, that comes up with respect to our relationship to Israel or legislation that impacts Israel in any way, Elliot, Brad Schneider, and a couple of others meet in my office, and we go through what ought to be done. Elliot is an extraordinary leader. Strong voice on behalf of our relationship with Israel and issues that relate to Israel's welfare and security.
Yeah. It was amazing.
Selma, Montgomery, and Birmingham. The pilgrimage that John Lewis takes on the walk across the MTS Bridge. Tell people that I believe strongly in the separation of church and state. But I do not believe in the separation of the values that my faith teaches me and the policies that I pursue. Critically important. One of the reasons I was so strong last night was because I know there is doubt. Does the Democratic Party represent me? Is the Democratic Party going to be with Israel? Are we safe to support them? Mm-hmm. And I was there last night to say, yes, you are. And that's what you're saying. It's important for our country, and it's important for Israel. If Israel ever loses bipartisan support, there will be a danger. We need to make sure that we call out, whether they're Democrats or Republicans or no party, people who talk about things that are clearly anti-Semitic or represent anti-Semitic views. We need to make sure that we say, no, that is not us. That's not America. We've been there. We've done that. We know the results. So when you see anti-Semitism, you've got to cut it out as soon as you can get it. It's like early diagnosis, that's cancer, that will kill. You do that, this organization does. As I did, try to tell her, I'm a Democrat, and I believe in Israel. I don't have dual loyalty to anybody. Last time I'm not gonna have a lot. But I tell every one of my constituents, it's important to you. It's important to your family and your children. It's important because Israel is the only democracy. If it falls, democracy is at risk. Constitutional government is at risk. We ought not to be ever so arrogant that we think, well, one goes, we're really fine. Mm-hmm. We've heard that story before. I'm saying that because I was not this strong. And what you do every day is so critical. Because you give a speech, I have to give a speech, well, that's fine. But as I told Brad Schneider's group, I just gave a Brad Schneider, it's what you do every day. Your neighbors, your friends, your relatives, your in-laws, whoever it is from your country, you reach out. Take a group to Israel. Everyone, Susan, you're going to go with me. I've been 15 times.
The only
reason
I ran for Congress.
That's why I supported her so well. Brendan mentioned, you know, I've been to Israel, as I said yesterday, 15 times. I was with Yossi on one of my visits. Anybody else here on one of the visits we took? Oh, right. we spent some time today. He and his son were there. Still here, right? But it makes such an impact. Talk about security. Unless you feel the proximity of danger, the threat, almost invariably, one of the delegation is a bomb. Why do you stay here? Why do you stay here with your children with danger just kilometers? Not even kilometers, less than a kilometer. And their response is invariable, because I'm not going to run any of that things in place to run.
It's
safe. And that's why Israel has to respond immediately and emphatically, because it doesn't have three thousands of miles of water on the east, or 3,000 of miles on the west. It's right there. That is why we have to make sure that members of Congress who will vote on issues literally of life, of survival. This democracy that I said last night was in the midst of dictatorships, and potentates, non-democratic states, who unfortunately have people who spew hate, bigotry, violence. Very likely if Canada will pose such a threat, or Mexico will pose such a threat, neither Canada nor Mexico would exist. When people say, well, they overreacted, I say, what do you mean they overreacted? Their children are being subjected to rocket fire. So thank you for what you do. This organization, the organizations that you're members of, to let people know how critically important it is that we never forget, and that we allow anti-Semitism or hatred or violence